Black Alpha Network, home of Black excellence.
What's up, Black world? Black brothers, black sisters, black queens, black kings, black goddess, and all the gods. One love, y'all. What's poppin'? I'm back at it. Hey, I've been away for a while. I've been up and down, traveling on the road, but I've been keeping my thumb on the pulse of everything. I've been seeing every single piece of shit that's going on in our society and everything that's going on in our community. And I'm here to let you know we're gonna stay together and we're gonna ride together. And I'm right here with you for life. Bet that. But we're gonna talk about race refunds today. A motherfucking race refund. Yes, the importance of being right the first time. I let folks know when I'm speaking to them, I say sometimes in life you just want a motherfucker to get it right the first time. All this, well, he made a mistake, or my bad dog, or maybe the next time. Man, it fuck that. It ain't always another time where you can do a redo. You ain't always got time to be repaving the fucking road. Sometimes when you speak to a person, you want the message delivered, message received. We understand sometimes it ain't gonna always work that way, but it's cool sometimes. Alright, but that sometimes shit motherfuckers like to stretch out, and sometimes can turn into all the motherfucking times if you don't correct it. So we need to get things right the first time, especially when you're under siege and you being pressed like we being pressed. There's an onus that we got to get shit correct, we got to be accurate, we got to be on point. So if a motherfucker is not on point, if a motherfucker gets shit wrong and they think they got 4, 5, 6, 7 times, they need to sit their ass down. And all of our leaders, all of our real ones, all of our riders, all of our intelligent folks, we need to be the ones controlling this, because we're going to be the ones who get this shit correct. These kids in the future and everybody coming up, they don't have time for the motherfucking mistakes. You know, this the fourth quarter, man. We ain't got motherfucking time. It's too late in the game. It's too late in the day. The sun is set. Now, either your ass is going to be inside that fucking house, or your ass is going to be out here in the motherfucking jungle. When you out and you see that sunset and you better get your ass home, you better get your ass home. Ain't no my bad dogs. Because sometimes my bad dog can be your motherfucking end. So we're going to get straight to the point, and we're going to talk about being accurate and not having no goddamn race refunds. Ain't no redos. Ain't no do-overs. This shit where we keep fucking up every generation makes a mistake, makes another mistake, makes another mistake. Then you learn from it. Then you make another mistake. I mean, we got the power to look back on things that were done wrong in the past. We can look back to the 20s, the 30s, the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, 2000s. We can look back on all that. And we see all of the mistakes. I'm a historian. You're probably a historian. Most conscious black folks are historians. We know our people all the way back from Africa to the plantation to right now on the block. We know our people and we study them. We study all of the things that went wrong and we study the things that they did right. And it ain't hard. The blueprint has been laid out. We done had all of the smartest, most thorough, powerful people on the planet. Trust me, we're not at a lack of intelligence. We're not at a lack of leaders. We're not at a lack of riders and soldiers. No, we got all that shit, past, present, and in the future. The problem is motherfuckers don't learn from it. What they always say? They said if you don't study the past or know your past, then you're not gonna be able to know your future. Well, here's the problem. Motherfuckers know their past. They just don't translate that knowing into action. And you got to be a person of action. You got to be a queen of action. You got to be a king of action. If you just sit there and read motherfucking books all day and say, well, you know what happened was the black folks in Black Wall Street, what they should have did, you know them should have did niggas, the coulda, woulda, shoulda, if he would have just done this way. And then you get up and you don't do none of the shit you just talked about. Your intelligence stays on that computer. Your intelligence stays on the book. It comes to a point where you got to take the shit that you read and translate that shit out here in this motherfucking world. And that's why you got to learn from the past and do real studying of it. Not just knowing it. Take the lessons and apply them to today. And that's what we're going to do right here on the Black motherfucking AlphaCast, because I'm in this motherfucking building. This is Black Alpha 6, and I salute all of my family. FBA, B1 Riders. I've been screaming it from day one, and I'm gonna keep on screaming that shit, cause it ain't no end with us, baby. This is the motherfucking family. I hope y'all certified summer has been lovely. I hope your day is doing good. I hope you're living a blessed life, your best life. Hope everything is falling in line. I hope your ass got a promotion if you're going to work. I hope you went to your bank account and they got a bunch of zeros in that motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? I hope your family's doing good. I hope your kids are doing good in school. Hope your parents, your cousins, your auntie. I hope your motherfucker dogs and cats. I hope everybody doing goddamn good. If it's associated with us, I want to see it thriving. Because that's how deep my love runs. And that's how deep our love runs. And when you put us all together in the same motherfucking world at the same motherfucking time, we are unstoppable. So let's get to motherfucking work and let's do it our style, B-A-N. Bang that subscribe, bang that like, bang that notifications, because I said we building and this movement is on fire. So let's get it. All right, so what's a race refund? A race refund are these black folks out here who always got the right idea, the best idea, the most clever idea. They try to shame other black folks who think differently. They try to always steer us in another fucking direction. And 9 times out of 10, their asses be wrong. And then they throw their hands up and be like, no, I'm sorry, let's redo it. No, motherfucker, ain't no redo. You should have got it right the first time. And when all of us were trying to put you on game, you was that motherfucker saying you don't want to hear it. Y'all know that motherfucker. Y'all know now it's cool for everybody to be woke and conscious, but y'all know going back about 6-7 years ago, even further back, 12 years ago, anytime you brought up some shit to somebody, they'd be like, man, here you go with that black shit again. Remember that? Remember the, oh, he preaching. Remember the he preaching, nigga? Yeah. 9 times out of 10, that's the same motherfucker now trying to act like he's so black and he want to put everybody else on game. Nigga, 5 years ago, your ass was leaning and rocking. You was wiping your foot like Fabo, nigga, doing the Laffy Taffy. And now your ass is Massa Musa. Nigga, you went from Laffy Taffy to Wakanda. You went from Fabo to Massa Musa. Nigga, don't work that way. Sit your ass down. Sit your ass down. The motherfuckers who ain't qualified, the motherfuckers who just run their mouth, and they ain't providing nothing. They ain't contributing nothing. They ain't putting forth a goddamn thing. This is why our leaders and our smart folks got to step up to the plate. We ain't got to ask them. All right, because these motherfuckers ain't never gonna give this shit up willingly. We need to just push their ass to the side, give them race receipts, be a race regulator, and then let shit be known. Because if we allow these race refund motherfuckers, they'll be trying to get a refund every time. All they do is fuck up, get a refund. Fuck up, get a refund. Fuck up, get a refund. Next thing you know, you done blinked and 10 generations done went past. We are where we are right now. The reason why we have all these situations and these problems that have not been solved is because these niggas want a refund. It don't work that way. First off, these W supremacists ain't handing out no goddamn refunds, okay? Because they did that shit on purpose. The oppression, the suppression, the brutality, all of that is done on their watch on purpose. They ain't handing out no motherfucking refunds. So this shit where you think you gonna keep fucking up over and over and over and get a refund, it ain't gonna happen because now you sacrificing the youth. And as I say, the number one thing in this whole struggle is the youth. If you cannot look into the youth and get any type of motivation, sit your ass down. You don't deserve to be here. What Fred Hampton say? If you dare to struggle, then you dare to win. If you do not dare to struggle, then God damn it, you don't deserve to win. And I'm gonna take that a step further. And I'm gonna say, if you ain't down to struggle for the kids, then your ass don't deserve to be here at all. And we gonna get you up out of here off the block. You feel me? So the race refund, all these people who always are going in the wrong direction and they think we have time on our watch to just fix it in one night. It ain't. It's hard enough and so time consuming when you're being accurate, this shit is hard. When you got shit in order, when you see things correctly, this shit hard enough. So we ain't got the motherfucking time to be going off, bruh. You got to stay on motherfucking code and you got to stay correct. Anything other than that ain't worthy. I'm gonna give you a good example of somebody who wants a race refund, because these motherfuckers always want race refunds. Some say it out loud, some don't. Some admit to it, some won't. But we gonna call their ass out either motherfucking way, because that's how we do things on this B1 FBA BAN Black Alpha Cast. Black Democrats. These is the most race refund having motherfuckers you ever seen in your life. Every fucking 4 years, they come around and they pick some massa. Tell the whole goddamn world how Massa's so good. Oh, vote for Massa. He gonna save us. He gonna take racism away. We've came so far. The first black this, the first black that. And then they get everybody to vote. And then the shit does not come true. And then they say, can we get a refund? No, motherfucker. It don't work that way. Barack Obama. Y'all remember? Remember? They acted like Barack Obama was gonna fly in with a cape, take all black people out of oppression. I'm talking about black folks in America, black folks in the Caribbean, black folks in Africa. They act like this motherfucker was gonna be super Negro. He was gonna fly, take us all out of oppression. And then when they found out that shit didn't happen, they say, Barack didn't do anything for us. Yeah, and you voted for his ass twice. Not even that you voted for him twice on some shit like taxes, or you voted for him twice on some shit like the employment rate. No, you voted for him twice on some savior shit. He was gonna save black folks, and he never did. And then you sat back and you realized that he did something for everybody else. You look and he did something for that community. Y'all know who. He did something for that group. Y'all know them. He did something for that group over there. This motherfucker was doing things for groups that were behind groups. He was going, you, right there. Me? No. The guy behind you. Me? No. Him behind you in the 15th row. Yeah, come on up here. Let me write a law for you. Black folks is on the front of the line saying, what about us? And he was saying, I'm so in love. And niggas was going, woo! Oh, massa! Y'all know it's true. We seen this shit. We seen it. Shout out to Al Green, by the way. What the motherfuckers say? They say, I don't need him to goddamn sing for us. I got Al Green for that. And I don't need his ass to sing Al Green. Fuck out of here. You know what I'm saying? By the way, I don't even think that was I'm So In Love With You. I think the motherfucker was singing Amazing Grace or something. He probably sang a whole goddamn playlist. You know what I'm saying? For everybody else, that goddamn pen was working. For us, he was just going through the classic soul ballads. This nigga sang Luther Vandross. Anytime they start pressing his ass, he'd just pull out an old black soul song. The Jackson 5. This motherfucker was singing goddamn Marvin Gaye. Ain't No Mountain High Enough. Shit. This motherfucker ain't give a shit. Nigga, fuck Ain't No Mountain High Enough, nigga. How about a motherfucking law? And he didn't give us none. And those are just for the motherfuckers who admitted it. Because you still got people talking about, he did this, but Roland Martin, he did this, and he did this, and he did this. And they just start reaching. I told the motherfucker the other day, I said, hey, bro, your shoulder hurt? He said, no. Why? I said, because your ass is reaching. You done blew out your motherfucking AC joint, your rotator cuff torn, because you reaching down the motherfucking block trying to get an excuse. Own it. Own it. The race refunds ain't cool. It ain't a good look. And you always see this coming from Black Democrats. I mean, all the way. You can go all the way back to JFK. Since Black folks got the right to vote, they've always fucked up, put their vote behind the wrong person, and asked for a refund. And like I said, that's the motherfuckers who are even real enough to admit it. Because some people would just go down with the ship. Because facts don't matter. Facts don't matter when you start dealing with a slave mentality. No. Facts don't mean shit. A lot of these people just go down with the ship, save themselves the embarrassment. I told you before, first thing they do is they try to deny it. Then they try to shame everybody, or vice versa. They try to shame and deny. Either way, they try to hit you with one of those tactics. And then eventually they get proven wrong. And when they get proven wrong, they just play a code of silence. They don't say nothing. They can't get on Black First code. They can't get on the B1 code, but they can practice a damn code of silence every time they wrong. You know what I'm talking about? The same people that want to talk all this politics when Joe Biden got elected. Let's talk Joe Biden. Let's talk Kamala Harris. Let's talk about all the things that Massa gonna do for us. Come on, let's talk. Come on. You fast forward in time, none of the shit they said was gonna happen never happened. And they ass don't wanna talk politics. It's a lot of people's family. The dinner tables in the Black household was filled with a whole bunch of Black Democrats that wanted to talk about Joe Biden. Massa Joe. Now, a year later, they don't wanna talk about Joe no more. They said, let's just change the subject. How was school today? Did y'all see the ball game? Man, I heard some rains coming tonight. Nah, motherfucker, let's talk about Kamala. Yeah, let's talk about Kamala's sister girl. Y'all told me that was Aretha Franklin. Now you don't want to talk about it no more. Uh-huh. Let's talk about Massa Joe. Remember, you said anybody with Trump. Massa gonna do this, that, and the other thing. He ain't never did it. Can you pass the collard greens? Nah, motherfucker. We gonna pass this L on your ass. And you gonna hold it. And that's how it go. So that's Barack Obama, that's Joe Biden, that's Kamala Harris. Just think about all the gums they was flapping. And then look now, they want refunds. They want refunds. I seen some Democrats on TV the other day saying, Joe Biden hasn't fulfilled his promise to the Black community. How many times have you heard that one? That we haven't fulfilled our promise to the Black community? I got a homeboy. This man was trying to argue me tooth and nail about Joe Biden. Ever since the election, he ain't said shit. He ain't said nothing. His page and his timeline was full of Joe Biden all day long. Now that shit's filled with football teams. Don't say a goddamn thing. All of a sudden he disappeared. He took his ball and went home. You know, as we say, he folded his flag and he put it in the closet. He was on all that G shit. Now his ass on all that hush hush. That's what they do. The fulfilled promise thing, it's always happened. I mean, you can go back. I mean, you hear shit about America's never fulfilled their promise to the Black community. When I start asking this question, and we got to be real with it. Is it the person who told the promise fault? Or is it the motherfucker who keeps believing the false promises over and over and over? From a motherfucker who's made it clear that they don't fuck with you. The same person that you see oppressing you is the same person that's giving you a promise and you believe it? Whose fault is that? That's these race refund motherfuckers. Straight up and down. And we're here to put an end to that. And we're here to let it be known that I don't want to hear about no motherfucking promises. The only promise that's going to be made is going to be us getting shit done. Regulators getting shit done. So we don't want no race refunds. We'd rather give out them race receipts. And that's the whole dichotomy of the situation. Look at those two tales. Look at those two stories. You got one group of folks who always want a race refund. They bought some shit. Now they want it back. Then you got another group of folks who give out race receipts, which means they're always correct. They call shit before it happens. We sit the fuck back and we watch it occur. Watch it occur. Right now on Twitter, you see this Biden remorse. Yeah. Check it out. Get on Twitter, Instagram, all that shit. Biden remorse. That hashtag is trending heavy right now. I'm talking about super heavy. And all that is basically telling us that we were right about every goddamn thing we said. Everything we said. And it ain't no secret. We predicted it and we called it. Just like everything. I mean, this shit ain't nothing new. This is what we do, man. This is what we always motherfucking do. We've always done it. It's so sad that you got black folks who are so motherfucking accurate. Every major thing that's happened in our community, there's always somebody out there predicting before it happened. Everything. You can name it. There's motherfuckers back in the day saying, No. I ain't getting on that motherfucking boat. I ain't going that way. These motherfuckers is going to make us slaves. They're going to get us over there and we're going to be doing all types of fucked up shit. I ain't going that way, nigga. I'm running. There was niggas on the plantation saying, fuck that. No, you ain't going to get me, motherfucker. All that smiling and all that. Hi, come on over here. Pick this cotton. Yeah, the sugar cane's right there. We're your friend. There was a motherfucking black person saying, nope, fuck no. Ain't happening. About ain't. Shit. I'm going that way. I don't trust these motherfuckers. I'm out of here. Oh, yeah. There was millions of them. There was a motherfucker back in the day, black person, saying, nope, I don't trust that shit. I ain't going to Vietnam. Nope, Muhammad Ali. Straight up, I ain't going that war. Why? So we be on the front line? Fucks that. Nope, I'm going that way. I don't trust these motherfuckers. And it's the same way we today have said, nope, ain't no motherfucking way. I ain't voting for him because he's going to use our vote and he's going to take that shit, do nothing for us and use it against us. And we called it. Motherfuckers is calling it now. Motherfuckers was calling it then. You know, go back in time. There's motherfucking black folks on this shore before slavery, the original foundationals. And they seen them boats coming and said, nope. I don't trust the motherfuckers. All that shit when the motherfuckers was coming in and people were saying, hey, come on. Hey, how are you? No, fuck no. Motherfuckers was sitting here 10 toes down saying, who that is? Just like if a motherfucker drive over your block. How they do that shit on Friday? You know what I'm talking about. Car cut the lights off. Start driving real slow. Because where I'm from, if a motherfucking car goes a certain mile up my motherfucking street, if his ass is at a particular speed, we already eyeing his ass. Side eyeing him. You better drive the motherfucking speed limit, because if your ass get to halfway going slow, what we call that, y'all? We call that shit creeping. And as soon as a motherfucker look like they creeping, we side eyeing them. What they say on Friday? Drive by. And you watching that shit. Straight up. Ain't no good intentions in that. So when them motherfuckers was coming up on the shore and them real originals was here, not just the aboriginals, because remember, aboriginal means second to original. No, I'm talking about the originals. And then the aboriginals came and both the motherfuckers seen them folks coming on them ships and said, nah, fuck them. Drive by. They was creeping. And that's why you don't trust them. I tell folks all the time. I say, you'll go far in life just not trusting these motherfuckers. Do you got to be the smartest motherfucker in the room? Do you got to be able to break this shit down like our pillars and our leaders and our intellectuals in the community? No, not everybody's going to be on that level of intelligence. But I tell you what, if you just keep your eyes open, your third eye watching these motherfuckers, and you have a lack of trust, you'll go far. A lack of trust for your oppressor will save you without you ever having to know all of the details. Straight up and down. And that's the difference between us who hand out race receipts, us who are race regulators, and them who are people who want race refunds. You know what a refund is? These motherfuckers buy some shit, it ain't what the fuck they thought, then they try to get it in return. The masters say, fuck no. Fuck you mean? Too late now. We already in office. Too late now. You already picking cotton. Too late now. You already in shackles. Too late now. We already got your vote. Hey, a race refund is like these little cheap websites. You be seeing them little cheap websites that be selling knockoff off-brand shoes and shit. That's what a race refund is. That's what a race refund is. You order some Nikes, they send your ass some Ikes. You get some goddamn Ike Turners in the mail. They be making up characters and all different fucking designs. Hell no. The Nike check is flipped upside down. you order some Timberlands and you end up getting some damn Timberwoods. Don't be the goddamn color. You get a size motherfucking 11. Them shits come in as a size 4. And they got a big ass sign on the website. All sales are final. No refunds. That's how racism is. That is especially how anti-black racism is. They don't hand out no motherfucking refunds. You may want a race refund. You may say, I voted for the wrong guy. I picked the wrong group. I followed the wrong party. Can I get a refund? Masses say, nope, all sales are final. Just like them goddamn Timberwoods you bought off the internet. That's how it works. Ain't no refunds. So don't go looking for none, because they ain't going to give them to you. Tell you what you can get. You can get a race receipt. You can get regulated. And we're going to be the ones doing the regulations. Because while y'all still chasing the refunds, we stay on our work and we get our own. That's why they losing. And that's why we winning. It's going to stay that way. Yes, indeed. And that shit just goes over and over and over. A perpetual cycle of nothing. Got your ass running in place. And they'll have you running in place forever, because guess what? You're running. They're not. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Go back to slavery. Master sit on the motherfucking plantation and sit there and drink a motherfucking lemonade. He ain't the one out in the field sweating. He got the best shoes and the best clothes. He got dinner on the fucking table. He's sitting back relaxing. So he don't mind your dumb ass falling for shit wanting a refund every motherfucking weekend. He ain't getting it. He ain't getting it. And this is why we got to call these folks out. So this is why you have Biden remorse, the same way you had Obama remorse and Bill Clinton remorse. Go back to Bill Clinton. Let's rewind time. Let's go back to 92, 93 with Bill Clinton. Black folks is running out this motherfucker, kicking that same ignorant ass game, still talking, still wrong, still making mistakes, still talking that bullshit. Talking about, oh, Bill Clinton played the saxophone on Arsenio Hall show. Oh, he gonna save us. Because you know a saxophone means he loves black people, right? You don't even know a nigga that played the saxophone, but somehow a nigga playing the saxophone makes you think that's black. Black folks acting like this motherfucker was Miles Davis. Straight up and down. Straight up. That damn interview on Arsenio Hall show got him the black vote. Not anything he said about black folks, not his track record, not anything. Because remember, to a slave, facts don't matter. He went out there, played that goddamn saxophone on Arsenio Hall, got the black vote. And remember, black folks were running around talking about, oh, Bill Clinton, he the first black president. Remember, I mean, come on. Come on now. Come the fuck on. You got slaving and then you got slaving. If that ain't the most slave shit you ever heard. This motherfucker signed the 94 crime bill. Joe Biden wrote the 94 crime bill. Think about that. The motherfucking crime bill that broke up the black family was written by the guy who just got the black vote, signed by the guy we said was the first black president, and the guy who got the black vote now was the vice president for the black guy in the middle that we voted for because we said he was the first black president. God damn, that's a clusterfuck. You got the fake first black president who's really not black. Then you got the black guy who was with the white guy who said he was a black guy, and none of them did shit for black people. I hear a bunch of first blacks, but all I see was anti-black racism. Basically, what I see is a bunch of fucking mistakes. I see black folks chasing the wrong thing, going in the wrong direction, and later on saying they want a do-over, a refund, and it don't work that motherfucking way. If somebody keeps on selling you water and telling you it's wine, they gonna keep on selling it to you. And it's your job to cut that shit loose. It's on you. And the onus is always on us, because we're the only ones keeping the lights on. Like these motherfucking lights right here above me. We are the only ones keeping these lights on. We the only ones paying the bill. They not. Cause trust me, you leave it up to these folks, I ask them to be out here in the motherfucking street. And they be cool with it as long as it's in Master's plantation. You know? This is why we got to be on our motherfucking G and calling them out one by one. So that's the political race refund, and I'm not even gonna talk about the governors, the mayors, the city councilmen, the motherfucking senators, where they just be voting blindly as fuck and always making the wrong decision and wanting a goddamn refund. Go in Atlanta. They voted for that district attorney or some fucking body, and the first thing they did was reverse the Rashard Brooks case. That was the gentleman who got shot at Wendy's. I think they gave the cop his job back and everything. And we were calling it, all us receipt givers and all of us race regulators, we said, do not vote for this motherfucker. They are going to reverse that case on sight. And that is exactly what happened. Hey, y'all help me out in the comment section. Let me know. I cannot remember the name of the motherfucker they voted for. I think it was a district attorney in Atlanta. Check that out for me. Let me know, because I'm not sure right now. We family. Help me out on that one. But either way, we said, do not do it. Black folks is everywhere saying don't do it. And they still voted for this motherfucker. And the first thing they did was reverse the goddamn case. I think that cop got his job back and every fucking thing. You ever notice, you hear about the Breonna Taylor, you hear about the George Floyd, but you don't hear about Rashard Brooks. No. And what they do, they went back to that same race routine. The same thing they always do. the black community haven't always had their promises fulfilled. That same shit. They're running you in a circle over and over. And they was out here saying, oh, I can't believe they reversed the case. And that's just the motherfuckers who even spoke on it. Because a lot of them just went into hiding and said, oh, shit. Yeah, listen to how crazy this is. If you thought the shit with the black president and the black and the vice president and saxophones and all that shit was funny, listen to this clusterfuck. The same people that in 2020 were in the streets protesting on behalf of justice for Rashad Brooks are the same people who turned around and voted for a politician who dismissed the Rashad Brooks case. God damn, you can't even be more fucked up than that. I mean, listen, man, there's wrong and there's that shit. There's slaving and then there's that shit. Get real. The same motherfuckers who were protesting, trying to get that cop held accountable, are the same people who voted for the politician who let the cop get his job back. And they thought they did something. Man, get the fuck out of here. Race refunds. Another motherfucking way of saying race refund is a fuck up. Is a motherfucker who's always wrong. That's what it is. Straight up. We could say race refund because that's what they're asking for. They want their money back because they realize that they done made a mistake. But another translation for that is just a stupid motherfucker. Up and down, round and round. Print that. That's it. If you see somebody who's always making the motherfucking mistake and saying, my bad, let me do it again. Hold on, give me one more time. I know I messed up here, 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 and here. But I'll get it right this time. That's just a goddamn fool. We can come up with clever words. We can associate all these phrases with it. But I like to keep it nice and simple and call them a damn fool. And don't feel ashamed to say it. Do not feel ashamed to say it. No, no, no. Because remember, these are the same people that are always coming after us. Trying to shame us for not going with their mistakes. Trying to chastise us for not going with their mistakes. Every single thing that's been done wrong to the black community, there was a lot of motherfuckers supporting it. There's a lot of motherfuckers going on campaigns for it. Every bad politician, every bad supremacist, every atrocity, there was always motherfuckers going around trying to shame the real folks, trying to shame the intelligent folks to go along with it. So if that's the energy that they want to come with, they want to come with some old, man, well, y'all need to do it like this. And they so motherfucking adamant about making they fucking mistakes, then we're going to be adamant about being real ones. And we're going to check them. We're going to throw that smoke right back at them. Ain't going to be no, man, see, y'all messing up. See, now we got this shit, but we always want to say, where y'all at, Biden supporters? Where y'all at, Obama supporters? Man, fuck all that. Fuck all that. Because these people are shameless. Them same motherfuckers out there making all the mistakes, you can't tell them, I told you so. You know a motherfucker is low budget when you can't even say, I told you so. Because A, they're going to hide, two, they'll make excuses and dismiss it. Y'all see it all the time. You got motherfuckers still running around here talking about how slave masters did a good job. Oh yeah, oh yeah. You see how I just said there's always somebody supporting a mistake? Everything that's ever went wrong, everything. I seen black folks sit down and support George Zimmerman. I seen black folks sit here and support Kamala Harris. Everybody. There's always somebody out there making excuses for it. And later on trying to come back and redo it or just get quiet. There was a guy, y'all seen the letter? Go back and look at the guy. This is a black man who wrote a letter saying the black man should never be free. Ever. Go back to the end of slavery. Go check back. 1800s. Seen it. There was a guy who wrote a whole letter talking about how black folks should always be slaves. And basically we're all fucked because we're going to be free. He didn't want us to be free. He didn't want us. Straight up. He did not want us to be free. He said, nope, it's going to be bad for black folks to be free. Our destiny. This motherfucker's talking about destiny and our future was on the plantation. And we was wrong for wanting to be free. How dare us want to be free? He was talking about the whole existence of black folks ever since then to today. Me, you, every fucking body. Your grandma, your grandpa, every goddamn body. We was all bad black folks wanting to be free. We should just stay on the plantation. That's our destiny. You see that shit that they try to peddle? So this is why we got to get motherfucking real with it. And the onus is on us, and that's good. We like that shit. We like that shit. These is broad motherfucking shoulders. Broad shoulders. We don't care. Ain't nothing to it. Hey, we shine best when the lights is the brightest. That's how B1s operate. See, these other motherfuckers, they fold. They fold like a motherfucking lawn chair. When shit get real, they get quiet. When shit get real, they hide. We don't. We stand in the paint 10 toes down and we bring it right the fuck back. Ain't nothing to it. No way. Because we're going to do what we got to do to push this line and keep this B1 up high. We all passionate. We all motivated. We all focused. And we all special. And when you got somebody with all of those attributes and you got somebody with all of those skills, talent, shit, ain't no stopping it. Ain't no stopping it. Matter of fact, fuck that. They talented. We gifted. You know what I'm saying? We gifted. And we're going to push that line for everybody in the future because we understand accuracy and being accurate is the most important thing in this struggle. One more time. When you're in a struggle like us and you're dealing with the shit that we deal with, I'm talking about under siege from everybody. People coming at us from all angles. We like the motherfucker in the middle of the room, and you look to the right side, the left side, behind you, there's always somebody coming after us. And it ain't nothing, because we be sitting there swatting their asses all around. And that's why they don't like us. They don't like us because they all come after us and they all have to come and team up on us and pile up on us, and we still be serving them. Serving them. And that shit drives them insane. And I take pleasure from it. I take pleasure. You know, they go, hey, listen, we know they're going to come after FBAs. We know they're going to come after certifieds. And there's nothing I like better than to see people put all this energy in trying to derail us and trying to harm us. And we still stand, and then we pivot around them and we undelay their ass and they go crashing into the wall. I love that shit. I love the fact that we occupy so much space in these motherfuckers' head. We got 500 acres in their brain, rent free, rent motherfucking free. And they cannot phase us. They cannot phase us. And that just proves that we're on another level. But we already know that. You dig? So we keep on grinding, and everything we do is for the next generation because we are accurate. See, before, they would always fuck up. Fuck up, let the next generation handle it. We ain't got that kind of time. That's why we speak. Accuracy is the shit. You got to be accurate. You got to be precise. You got to be on point. Everything you do, your words, your lingo, your action, your ideas, your thoughts, how you ponder, the way you brainstorm, the way you unify, the way you connect, the way you galvanize. Every aspect of this struggle is based on accuracy. And understand, if you are 1 inch off, that can be the inch that matters the most. Play basketball, you don't play black power. All about action, and that's what we're about. It's like when you see the motherfucking Olympics, we were just watching it. When they're running and they pass that baton to the next person in line, you can't be out there stumbling, fumbling, and bumbling and shit. You can't fuck up and say, well, the next guy gonna get it. Fuck no. You make one mistake, you gonna lose. And that shit's in a matter of seconds. A matter of seconds. If a motherfucker's running, they don't have time for mistakes. They don't have time to catch their breath. They don't have time to trip. They gotta get it done like right now. And that's what we are. We gotta get this shit done right motherfucking now. You see when it come down to the end and it be a photo finish and they got to use the fucking camera and see who won? I remember Gail Devers. I don't know if y'all remember her. She was a great track athlete of the 90s. I was a youngster. I remember she beat some woman. I don't even remember. She literally beat this woman by her hair extension. She had her head forward and her hair extension went over that motherfucker and she won. That's how tight of a motherfucking race this is. Ain't no time for refunds. Ain't no time for refunds. We're going to get that motherfucking mop. We're going to get that broom. And we're going to start cleaning up all the fucking messes that they left for us. We already cleaning up what the civil rights era did. We already cleaning up for them good trouble motherfuckers. Now we about to put all that shit to rest. And we're going to make sure when we give this to the next generation, we're not giving them a bunch of messes. We're not saying, here's a mop. Here's a broom. Clean up the shit we did. No, we're going to give them some money. We're going to say, here's some wealth. Here's some liberty. Here's some justice. Here's some black soul. You take that and you run with it. Just like they passed the baton in the Olympics, we gonna pass this motherfucking game. You do that, you good. Certified. I spoke about it on my last episode. Check it. I say passing energy down is a beautiful thing. But if you can pass the energy with the wealth, with the knowledge, with the game, then you on one. And we on this motherfucker real time. Certified, baby. Black Alpha Network. Bang that subscribe button. Comment, share this with every real nigga you know all across the globe. I don't give a fuck. Share this with everyone, and we gonna chop game as a family. Pull up the table, pull up the chair. If you riding, crank this all the way up. So let's chop game the way we do, because it's very serious that we get this message through to the world. It's very serious that we get this energy popping, and it's very, very motherfucking serious that we don't waste time. And our people, that's you, me, all of us, we ain't about that time wasting. We all about action and we all about accomplishment. There's nothing in between. And we ain't really the failure type, you know what I'm saying? So that means that the accomplishments are already lined up. It's just here for us to knock them down one by one by one. And we already at it. If a motherfucker's just showing up, they better join in because this train is already in motion. And the next stop is wealth and prosperity. And I will see you there. Don't be late. Don't be late. When you late, that means you think there's a part two. Ain't no part two. Ain't no goddamn part two. The same way you got one life is the same reason why we got one race. We got one family. Us together. And if we don't do it, nobody's gonna do it. So that means there's an onus on that accuracy. There's an onus on being correct. There's an onus on passing this down. And the only way you can pass it down is if you attain it yourself. How the fuck you gonna pass something down to the next generation if you never got it yourself? If you never had it? The only way you could pass it down is you go out and get it by any means, then you own it by any means, and then you pass it down by any means. If you think that you just gonna say, well, nah, fuck it, I'll get it the next day. Next day ain't gonna come. Or I'll get it tomorrow. Tomorrow ain't gonna come. Because everybody wants what you got. Remember, if you think it, they thought it. You ain't the only motherfucker sitting there saying you want this. You ain't the only motherfucker sitting there saying you want that. You want wealth. You want money. No. Everybody's thinking that shit. Black folks don't understand. Just like the Olympics analogy. We in a motherfucking race and everybody's running. So no, we ain't into getting Joe Biden and passing him down to the next generation. I ain't trying to pass Kamala Harris down to the next generation. I'm not trying to pass the Democratic Party down to the next generation. And damn sure ain't passing down no mop and no broom. That ain't in the cards, player. Never have, never will be. Mm-mm. About ain't. You already know. And speak your mind. Let it be known. Do not bite your fucking tongue. Do not hold back. You see some off-code shit, check it. You see some off-brand shit, check it. I don't give a fuck who's doing the wrong. Check they ass. On point, on site. That's how you stay on code, and that's how the fuck we regulate, and we all race regulators. So that's the race refund. That's what it is. Go back to back in the day. Oh, if you do this religion, then you don't have to be a slave no more. Then we did that religion, wanted a refund. Oh, if you pick up your pants, then you can be free. We won't treat you bad no more. Then you picked up your pants, and they still shot you. Then you want a race refund. Then they say, vote for this guy. Then that's wrong. Race refund. They say, go over here. Do this. Race refund. Talk like this. Race refund. Think like this. Race refund. You keep doing it over and over and over. And then you come to find out they were lying to you the whole goddamn time. And then when you find out that they've lied to you, whether that's after 1 day, 2 days, 3 years, 10 years, 400 years, then you say, can I get a refund? And they say, no, because we never intend to say the real shit anyway. That's why you blaze your own path, you create your own destiny, and you control your own narrative. When you're doing that, you don't have to worry about it. Because remember, anytime you want a refund, mean that you was buying some shit someone else was selling. And watch who the seller is. Because that seller, the same person who's giving it to you, is the same person who can take it from you. One of my principles and one of my mottos is always this. And I want y'all to lock this in your brain. A lot of y'all may have heard this already. For those who haven't, let me talk to you. Remember, if you give somebody the ability to feed you, you've also given them the ability to starve you. So just don't buy it, because when you got your own shit, you already good. That's how we operate. And there's nothing more powerful, there's nothing more independent, and there's nothing more alpha than having your own shit. Know that, remember that, live by that. And we're going to keep on pushing, stay forward, stay focused, and bringing everything that we got to the table. Laying it all on the line. Laying it all on the line. Salute. But all right, y'all, that's today's episode of the Black Alpha Network, Black Alpha Cast. Love chopping it up with y'all. My favorite thing in the whole motherfucking world. Y'all know that by now, because I always say it. What love to y'all, man. Keep doing your thing. This B1 certified season, certified summer, certified era is in full motherfucking swing. And we in full motherfucking control. We ain't out here asking for no motherfucking refunds. We ain't asking for no motherfucking handouts. Only thing we doing is bringing that real live black soul. And if you ain't on that, then you ain't with us. And if you ain't with us, then you ain't doing nothing. Know that. Hey, hit that subscribe, hit that comment, share. I'm building this thing from the bottom up. All the way to the top, we will not stop. They say sky's the limit. I say ain't no motherfucking limit. You feel me? This B1 train don't stop for nobody. FBA certified black society. One love to all my certifies. Best thing you do today is go out there and be black. Be unapologetic. Let everybody know where you stand. Hold it down and keep pushing this line further and further and further every day. I got more content coming. I'm gonna keep flooding these waves with nothing but real shit, nothing but good shit. And all of us are gonna do what we always do together. We're gonna stay B1 and stay true, because we work together, we grind together. That means we shine together. Hit that subscribe, baby. One love, Black Alpha Network, because black is beautiful. And you already know, beautiful is black.